Human beings in the really, really past, they didn't used to eat that much. It's only in the phase of the indulgement that we have so much, you know, the Roman Empire, the Greek, where the rich were chubbier because they had so much food, while the poor were like skinny, but still very strong. Every major religion has fasting. In the beginning, those fasting were to clean yourself up, to face your God. So it was a spiritual fast, and they felt cleansed and clear, and they could get messages, downloads, third eye openings. Buddha fasted for 40 days in his meditation. Muhammad used to fast every Monday and every Thursday. In the Jewish religions, there's four big fasts all the time. Jesus used to fast, and his disciples used to fast. Fasting is a part of every major religion. It's only that back in the day, they didn't say why. And today we understand why, because it clears you. It clears your consciousness and it balances you.
There are a lot of different aspects and theories. We just like see one of them now, that is the physical body, the emotional body, the mental body, and the spiritual body.
When a person becomes a breatharian, first the 10-day process is an amazing process, but it's the beginning of the journey. It's the beginning of the decision to stay like that for at least a few months, to experience it deeply, including the ridicule and the social paradigms that people don't understand. It includes everything. It's like a package. What I can see is that a person becomes more of his true self. Meaning, if you have preordained yourself to be something in this world, then you're becoming more of that. I can see that the musicians become even more musicians. The stubborn become even more stubborn. The childish even more childish. It's like you're connecting more with yourself. And I can understand that it's more a removal of the limitation that is caused by overeating. And overeating is pretty much everyone. We eat the wrong stuff, and we eat the wrong amount. Like if a person will go under a certain amount, it will allow his body to be completely clean all the time. But society has taught us, and since we were little children, we've been eating plates that are going bigger and bigger and not necessarily the good stuff. So we're actually removing that limitation, and when we are removing that limitation, the person can actually become who he was supposed to be, without the time it takes the consciousness to digest, as the digestive system takes 25-30% of all the energy of the body, including in the mind. So when people stop eating, when breatharians become breatharians, they suddenly have this clarity, much more clarity about things. Ideas come easier. And I call it the letting go. The letting go of who you think you are to become who you really are. And the letting go also includes stop thinking so much. Let spirit do the thinking for you. It guides you in everywhere you do and everyone you meet anyway. So just let go. Stop being in the past, analyzing whatever it is that you did wrong. Stop being in the future. The future is not going to be according to what you plan anyway. Be in the present. In the present moment, there's not a lot of thinking to do. There's just being.
Imagine you were here with one of your brothers or sisters. That is such a cool experience together as a family.
It would be cool.
So from this 10-day process, I expect a deep connection to my spiritual self. So I know that when I do deep meditations, I really connect to my true self, this greater consciousness that I understand is true. You know, you can call it God, you can call it the quantum field, consciousness, source, whatever. So definitely a connection to that, a search to really connect there is really important to me.
I have expectations that I won't be eating as much food and hopefully not sleeping as much. If I could say my ultimate goal would be to eat a lot less, if not needing to eat anymore, sleeping less, and all the benefits that come with more time from taking away my energy from preparing food and eating food and sleeping so often.
What do I expect? I try not to think about it. Yeah, I don't want to think about it. I could get fear. I don't have too much fear. I woke up this morning with fear. Maybe after my dreams, I don't know. And then it went away. But I don't want to, no. I don't want to rationalize it.
The idea here for me is to expand my consciousness, to expand my ability, and then just take the next step. And I don't even know what the next step is going to be right now, but this is, I had a very strong intuitive drive to be here, and I live my life off intuition. So this is, and I'm already starting to expand my consciousness, just being here with these awesome people and in this amazing place and meeting Ray. It's been incredible so far, and we haven't even really started the drive fast, which in my mind is going to be a huge mental release for me.
Like, everything is new and I'm open to what it will be. I expect there to be challenges, and more than anything I'm just grateful, because I know that there's a strength that goes way beyond my mind that will get me through it, and I have faith in that.
Close our eyes. Try to sit with our back straight and begin to breathe. We can take long, deep breaths, and in every breath we feel ourselves completely filled up with energy and with air. And to begin, we'll take three synchronized breaths together. Inhale through the nose and exhale, just like a balloon. And I want you to imagine that apart from air, your body is also taking...
The beauty of the process is that you don't expect it to be so deep, but it is the most deep type of cleansing you can have emotionally and physically.
The process is designed in a way that we see the four bodies, we recognize the four bodies inside of us, as we said, the physical one, the emotional one, the mental one, and the spiritual one. And we want to give different contents in these bodies, so those different bodies inside of us will come into a deeper integration. This combining with the breathing exercises and the daily meditation creates a whole integration, so the person can come from a place that he is to the place that he desires to be nourished more from energy and not only purely on food.
I've decided for me personally that this has been a journey that helps me better understand my how I get energy and why it is I do the things that I do.
I feel like now in my life there is a lot of resistance to things, and I would like to come to a place where I can drop this resistance and be more open to be in my true path and to do good in my true path.
I am here to take greater responsibility for myself. I am here to receive the support of this group and teachers. And I'm here to add my power and energy to this group. And this is a co-evolution, and this is beautiful.
For me, it's just another outward expression of how powerful the human mind is. And I like to teach people and help them reach their own power, so this is just a good demonstration for people to hold on to. So that's why I'm here.
The main reasons I came that I really, really wanted to do this process is because I'm a healer. I really truly believe if I'm connected to my higher self, I'll be able to be more open and I could heal others.
There's always in the back of my head, the ultimate would be breatharian, because you can be out here a lot longer with a lot less, and that's kind of the golden ticket for that world. Like, you're free.
We can go and just explore areas that we would never explored and you know, try and look outside of ourselves for answers about life, but when you really look inside yourself, you find the universe. So it all resides within yourself. So this is a personal journey that I think will help me help others.
Ever since I became a breatharian, a lot of things have changed for me. First, I started teaching this type of lifestyle. I did workshops and I became like a guide. It really changed me on a deeper level. As a man, I became more feminine, more patient. I became the observer of my actions, so I can learn from a mistake much quicker because I admit it's a mistake. And when somebody tells me something, then I don't immediately resist and the ego comes out and say, no, absolutely not, there's okay and not okay, no. I just say, you know something? I'm gonna think about whatever it is that you said, that has been said. I will contemplate it and I will try to see where he is right first. So when the ego is reduced, it's really easy to do those things. But it's much deeper than that. I think that ever since I've been breatharian, I've been meeting people with a higher vibration because I am emanating this vibration outside of the universe. So I'm beginning to meet more and more people that are equivalent in the same frequency, that want to change the universe, want to change the planet for the better, that feel good with themselves and have a higher acceptance of themselves. It's about self-love and non-judgment.
Now the purpose of the whole exercises is to actually stretch and rebalance the chakras. We're lying down straight, just like you are right now. Our palms are touching the ground towards down, and from this position, we'll raise our heads until our chin touches the chest and our legs in a straight towards up. We will be sitting like this on our knees. If it hurts you something, you can put a pillow underneath your knees. Both hands go behind
as
you inhale. Stretch the back, hands go backwards in order to give more space to the lungs. And exhale until the chin touches the chest, hands go forward and go. So, from the starting position, chin touches the chest, and we go up. Our head is tilted back completely, we feel the stretch, and go down again. In this one, we breathe when we go up, and exhale. Every time, in every position.
Today, I'm feeling light, and there is a subtle hint of hunger, but it's not very strong.
So emotionally, I'm feeling pretty euphoric. A lot of group of people here and a lot of energy, so it's hard to tell entirely with that going on, because baseline here seems pretty high. Mentally, I'm really excited. I just feel like it's possible. That's where I'm at today is expansive opening, feeling it's possible. And physically, I'm feeling weak today. Not extremely weak, but I'm definitely low on my energy. I wouldn't want to go for a hike.
No hunger. I prepared for this process by spending a month on just juice and broth. So I'm getting used to that sensation of just not really being hungry. And I feel like my energy system's really excited about going to this level. So I'm not afraid of sort of hunger or not hunger, that kind of thing.
I'm really tired, emotionally tired, and I spent like part of the morning crying in my room, and I've discovered emotions I didn't know I have, and like lacks and like some voids.
Right now I'm feeling great. I slept great last night. I literally haven't had a full glass of water or a piece of fruit yet today. My energy's fine. Emotionally, I'm feeling very level. Mentally, I feel like I'm already starting to open up. Like I'm already starting to get new ideas, new revelations, new perceptions, new associations within my mind. Like as I sit and just think, like I'm thinking differently. So I am noticing already that things are happening, but I haven't had any extreme shift in the way I feel physically.
It's the second day of the initiation process. We're beginning a two-day manifestation workshop. Every day we work for 2 hours. Understand what does it mean to be a manifester? A manifester is a person that understands that his thoughts and his emotions and his general state of being always emanates towards the outside, whatever it is that he's feeling, thinking, and wanting. It's sort of like saying to the universe, this is what I expect you to bring me.
And we put it also in the beginning, because this is our base, to understand that we are the creators of our reality. We manifest our reality.
In this exercise, we're going to split into twos. Partners, don't be with each other, okay? Just meet other people. You're going to talk about the last year that you had as if it was a year from now in the future, okay? As if tomorrow started a new year, and you're talking about the year that you just had. And you're going to talk about the best, absolutely, year of your life. Open yourself up and understand that you are the only ones that are limiting yourself, okay? This exercise is supposed to open everything you really want and to make you realize that you can get a lot of the things that you want, okay? Ask yourself what makes you happy. What do you really want to do? And you'll find out that a lot of the things you're going to describe are things that are within your reach, okay? Now the other person, each one gets about 70.
We wanted in the beginning of the workshop already to give these tools and to enhance this responsibility inside of ourselves. Because what we're doing here is we manifest our reality. In this workshop, it's not the like, okay, come, the guides will make you the magic and then you'll be pranic. You are working it yourself. We are here for you to just aid you, to help you to activate inside of yourself what is already there.
The purpose is to begin the 10-day process with the understanding that certain things that we've been taught, they're not real. This is just an illusion, a part of the illusion of life. And the more we go into it, the more we understand that we are a spirit in human form, and our will and our intention has a lot to do with whatever it is that we experience in life. So to be a breatharian, one of the things that are very important is to be a manifester. First of your own reality, beginning with your physical body, to manifest health, to manifest abundance in your own reality and creation. And afterwards you go out into the world and you understand that you can use this manifestation ability to everything else, absolutely everything else.
Morning. We've had our first session, and right now I'm feeling really good. I'm not hungry, I'm not thirsty. You know, going into this process, I'm doing much better than I thought I would.
You know, this is part day three, part interview three, I guess. So my body's feeling amazing. Like I get up in the morning, not tired, but I do get up kind of slowly, slower than normal. I did brush my teeth today. Didn't feel like I needed that water, even though I didn't have water for since yesterday. Knowing that this is the last day for water, I don't want it. Well, not want it, but I don't need it. So I actually just, I don't crave it. I know that I can continue today without water, but sometime today I'll drink a cup or two of water, just you know, because, you know, 4 days, I'm gonna miss 5 days, you know.
When I woke up this morning, I had some discomfort in my abdomen, sort of what I would describe as around the first chakra, kind of blocks or pain even. And after our meditation, really drawing the energy up and feeling it move through the body and being really intentional about it, it's all gone. So that's really cool to notice.
So it's been really interesting physically, the sensations. So we did, you know, fruit the first day, juice yesterday, and just water today. And my hunger's been, I haven't had a lot of hunger, but there's definitely been hunger there. I woke up this morning, I wasn't hungry at all. Actually, I went to the bathroom, my pee was like neon orange, which is apparently part of the detox. So I'm starting to detox now. As far as my actual like hunger, it's been very mild. Like it comes and it goes, but it's never like pain, you know? Like I wasn't hungry at all when I woke up this morning. And during the first meeting we had today, I got a little hungry, but it wasn't intense like I would expect after, you know, yesterday literally all I had was 2 glasses of juice. And today I've literally just had like a half a bottle of water, and I haven't been very hungry, and it's really cool. And I hope that maintains through the dry fast, because now when I get that feeling of hunger, I can kind of douse it with a little bit of water, because today is the water day. But after today, it's just mind over matter. So we'll see what happens.
We have 4 different things that nourish us. Food, without food, a few weeks or a month will die, supposedly. Without water, 3 days will die, supposedly. Without air, just a few minutes. And without prana, nothing can really exist.
Prana is life energy that exists in everywhere, exists in me, exists in you, exists in the sky, in this earth, in the trees, everywhere.
Prana is a type of energy that exists everywhere. It is a dormant engine that most people use very, very little. When we are completely happy with what we're doing, when we are in love, we're completely being nourished energetically. Prana workshop is connect us with the spiritual body to understand a little bit more what we're going to be working with. We share our own experiences as guides, and we give a lot of information in regard to what is the energy of prana, how can it exist in everything, how can we use it, how certain people are already using it to being nourished by it.
I woke up this morning, I felt fine. I was actually more tired yesterday than I have been today. Like I took a nap yesterday. I haven't even taken a nap today. I've been down to the river twice already.
Okay.
Like I've been hiking around. Like my heart has been, like my blood pressure is low. Like I got a little lightheaded. At one point I stood up too fast and I was a little lightheaded. And my heart has been, like when I hike up those stairs right there, it's like, because the blood pressure is low and it's just trying to keep the blood flowing. As far as my actual energy, like, I'm feeling pretty good, man.
I woke up at 6 and I was like, let me just lie in bed. I feel like, you know, checking myself. I'm like, all right, my nose is not coming back. You know, that's my biggest concern. My nose was bothering me the last couple of days. So it didn't. And then 7:30, I got up. You know, I got ready. I went there early. You know, I thought I was fine. I was walking and all of a sudden, I see Michelle. She's sitting on the chair facing the sun, looks great. I get to her and I'm talking to her and I was like out of breath.
Falun Gong, Falun Dafa is some kind of a practice method that is from China. And it spread, it started in 1992, and like in 7 years it spread to 100 million practitioners through the world. 7 years, 100 million practitioners. Today I don't even know how much it is. This was like around 2000, so imagine. It is spread really fast, I think, because it combines also energetic exercise. It really purifies the body, cleans the body, move all the channels, like really open all the channels of the energetic body. And it also, when people practice it for some time, it is really enhancing three basic principles of life, which is truthfulness, compassion, and forbearance.
I have any thirst. I have cotton mouth that's driving me crazy, but the biggest challenge for me is I just have heart palpitations and I'm just breathing through it, and even in the night I just tell myself, you are capable, you are capable, you are capable, and I just let that reverberate through my body, you are capable. I set my intention for this process to be ease, smooth, peaceful, and successful, and I hold that, you know, and there's times it's challenging, but really, it's been a lot easier than I thought it would be. I really miss my wife. I haven't been emotional, but that's the one thing.
I don't feel like crying. I don't know. I'm just going through things. And
thank you for sharing.
I feel surprisingly good. I don't have the dry mouth yet, and I have good energy, and I've been napping, luxurious napping. All up until now, so I feel good.
My ears are popping like crazy, and my heart, you know, up and down, just like you said. I get a little depressed here and there, but like it doesn't last long. It just kind of like lasts for a couple seconds and it goes away. But all in all, I know everything will be well, so I'm okay.
I feel really weak. You know, like I woke up and slept like 12 hours, 3 days in a row. So I thought it'd be good. As soon as I started walking up here, I was out of breath, which was, and I don't think I've ever felt that, you know, in years. When we were doing the exercise, it was really hard for me. I had to sit down. You know, my heart's been racing like crazy. I guess, you know, just pumping harder, pressure is low. My stomach's been feeling very uncomfortable. I don't even know, like, I don't know if it's shrinking or if there's energy moving through it just all night, today, all day, just constantly. Like, something's going on in there. I don't understand it.
Until yesterday, I was feeling pretty good. And today it's like, my body feels very heavy. I'm moving slower than usual. I feel a little weak, but the sensations out of my body, I feel very good. Like the wind, the water. I'm very conscious of my breathing. My breathing actually feel better. And I just feel like laying in the sun and doing nothing. And I'm fantasizing a lot about food. I think if I would do this process by myself, I would already grab something to eat. So being in a group helps to stay focused. And when you were talking about the four bodies, I knew that it was the emotional body that needs healing the most for me. And I'm just trying to express my emotions more freely and feel them.
And in the fourth day, people are, some of them are really in the ease and see that, wow, it's the first day of the dry fast, I haven't eaten in 4 days anything, before that I haven't eaten for a week, only raw food, and they begin to see that if they're not too weak, they're gonna be fine. But the second day, they feel that they're gonna be fine even more, even though it's a complete silence day. Yeah, so, but it's so individual, so individual. Some people here are gonna have a difficult time because they choose to have a difficult time. It's not the choice that they make consciously. It's just the type of person they are. They have a belief that when you stop drinking water, then you become dehydrated and you become weak and in pains. And that belief is slowly going away. It's slowly disappearing. And it's hard for them to deal with that. So they still have some remnants. And that's why they have waves. Some people are up and high and energetic, others are low, and sometimes it switches, you know, these that are low, they become high. Every day is different, morning is different, evening is different, according to the activity we do. Focus on the singing of the birds and the sounds of the fire. When you're becoming a breatharian, you're more self-aware. First, all your senses are a little bit more sharp. And the second thing that happens is that you understand how much control your thoughts have over your body, because you've actually created a different system. You've opened an ancient engine that really knows how to live more from energy than from regular food. So you understand, wait a second, I don't have to be sick. Why do I have to be sick? And you understand that as a breatharian, because your body is completely clean of toxins all the time, you are going to live much longer without being sick. And when you understand those things, you become more self-aware.
mind game. It's not, eating is a mind game. You don't really need to eat, but we've been conditioned to eat. Like, what you think you need to eat is not, it's not true. You get fed already. You are 100% taken care of, but you don't know that or understand that because we haven't had that time, that moment in time to experience, you know, that nourishment. And now that it's becoming very abundantly clear with it, eating is just part of the game of enjoyment, but it can really take you on a very tricky road because you become addicted, you become the cravings, you become the sensations of it, and it can hold you prisoner.
Channeling is one of the many, many different tools we have for connection with our higher self. Our higher self is the one that knows exactly who we are, better than what we think we are. We are playing, our ego is playing a part here, but he does not know really who we are.
And this is what it's all about, aiming our intention, connecting to this, not letting our mind disturb us, and then we could really communicate with different things, ask questions, have guidance, aid to other people. And just in a simple way, not like the channeling, I don't know, I'm a medium, blah, blah, blah. No, really simple, really, really simple.
So this is going to be a beginner's introduction to channeling workshop, okay? Now, channeling is something that we're doing all the time anyway. We're just channeling ourselves. And if I listen to my heart, then I will know to be inside my emotions and not neglecting them, like a lot of men do. Like I will say, you know something? I'm jealous right now. And the fact that I'm observing this jealousy and admitting that I'm jealous, half of the jealousy will go away immediately. Just because I'm there with it, you know, or I'm afraid, you know, I'm afraid to lose this person. I'm afraid to be without money or without income. There's fears, but when I admit them, I face them. I face the challenge.
To see it's not about something so crazy. No, you can just like really channel your heart. See what it feels, what it has to tell you, what you can maybe guide you, what message it has for you, what it can ask from you. Channel maybe your higher guidance and your higher self. And that the people will have the possibility to just connect to it in a much more simple way than what they thought in the past.
Yesterday I wasn't really tired too much. I had a lot of energy and did some yoga, some self-reflection there, and then I saw this little dragonfly, and he called me forth. It's about 10 feet away from me, a little red dragonfly, but I seen a sign earlier in the day that I was going to see him for some reason. I just saw a dragonfly and there he was, so I approached him and had a conversation with him for about 45 minutes. And it's just so amazing watching a little animal like that. Like, he sat there on this little stick of bamboo and he was actually watching all the bugs flying by him while he was watching me. And he would move his head very fast and scan the sky, almost like a computer. And he'd scan the sky and then back to me, scan it and back to me. And then he'd fly off and grab a bug and bring it back and show me the bug and eat it right in front of me. And he did that like multiple times.
I've been thinking about my life, like what I want to do with my life, and having some clarity.
Since yesterday morning I've been really tired, and I have nausea in the morning, sometimes in the afternoon too. I'm really tired, I don't feel like doing anything, I don't have the energy to
just concentrate on a book, or I can just do like 20 minutes at a time. So yesterday in the silence day, I was expecting to have some emotional breakthrough, cry, or even some spiritual breakthrough. I hear people and I sing Prana in the Sky. I would like to have something special happening, but absolutely nothing special happened, and I even so emotionally also. So I thought maybe I'm not doing this right. So I was a bit worried.
My big ahas emotionally have been something I already knew. When we all went to the river the other day, I watched everybody get in. And I thought, I don't want to do it. Sorry, my heart's racing. I'm trying to breathe. And everybody was having fun, and I thought, you know, Rachel, you hold yourself back all the time. Take off your shoes. And I did, and I had so much fun.
The next workshop, still working and balancing our spiritual and emotional body in the cleansing, is the forgiveness workshop. But it's much more than that. It's much deeper than that. Participants actually go into a few hours inside themselves, and the exercise itself is remembrance of who you were, understanding that every person you ever encountered, negative experience or positive experience, has some karmic tension. And then you go into this like imaginative safe zone for yourself, and you go through a process individually with this person. Okay, it can be a relative, it can be an ex, it can be a student or a colleague, it can be whoever you want it to be. And you go through this phase of forgiveness. You forgive him, he forgives you for everything that you've done deliberately, not deliberately, consciously, not consciously, directly, indirectly. After that, there's gratitude and understanding, a deep understanding that this person has been a part of your life for a reason. Doesn't matter how your 3D self thinks of it as good or bad. And after that, there is love. You appreciate, you understand, you give each other a hug, even if it's really, really difficult for you.
We're going to start remembering everything and who we are from as early as possible, going with the time and with different memories. And while we're going through our own memories and remembering everything and why we are who we are today, then we meet different people that we have some sort of karmic tension with them, okay? Mm-hmm. Some people that we need to let go, some people we need to forgive, some people that we need to say sorry to, okay? And each person like that, we write it in the list, that's why we have the pages, because others will be added immediately after, and you see the list becomes really, really long. And with our time, and when we feel comfortable with it, we take him into our sacred place, okay? We take him into a place that we're very comfortable. We have the ultimate sofa there, you know, one of these ones that you're going inside like this, inside the cushion, and feel like, oh my God, this is so amazing. And then you go through a process with him, a personal process. And some people, you're going to have to do this process with them a few times. Thank you.
today we're going to have the water ceremony, which is a really, really big moment for a lot of the participants. It means that this is the fourth day of their dry fasting, no food, no water. And according to science, yesterday and today, most of them should have already died, be completely dehydrated, no energy whatsoever, sleeping all the day and being deflated of energy.
People don't so much think on food anymore. They just think, you know, what they want is water. But at the same time, we really encourage people to understand their ability to go further than this almost 4 days. If people were like asked to do 5 days, so they would probably do it.
Whoever's missing, get over here.
Where are the other jugs?
Here they come.
Yeah.
And the last one. Take one for Val.
I'm waiting.
He's not doing it.
All right.
Pranic cup.
Thank you.
We're always like right out, just like right.
So what's going to happen is that we're going to go in pairs to the middle, and each one is going to give his intention to the water and his love and his gratitude. This is spring water.
Mini wakan we choni yelo, 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 hey hey ah wakan tanga tunka shila, mini wakan we choni yelo, mini wakan we choni yelo.
Like nothing else. I've never in my life been deprived of water. Never knew how important water is and how much it meant to me. I love water.
It was the best water I drank in my life. It was like heaven. I could really sense that it was very powerful water because of our intentions we put in there. And yeah, man, it was really refreshing. I felt a complete, like I've been kind of building up this surrender, you know, to just to my body, to the elements, to the process, and it reached its peak. I've never felt so completely surrendered in my life.
The water was like nirvana. It totally changed my relationship with water, this whole experience. I mean, even before the water ceremony, I was jumping in the sprinklers, which were ice cold, and I would normally never do that, but it's just all of a sudden it's like, yes, water, it's amazing, it's beautiful, and drinking in the ceremony was, I mean, the ceremony was so beautiful, and it's like, I was amazed how happy I was.
Life. You just are so grateful for that element on the earth, and tears, laughter, everything just floods in, and it just feels so good.
The way you poured it, I saw it being poured, it's just like the ripples, just like, just water itself is just, oh my goodness.
just want to look at it for hours before I drink it. But I want to drink it.
No, you don't.
God, thank you for this water. All right. This is a very powerful moment. Boy, that tastes so good. Oh my goodness, you're right about the sweetness of it. It just like washes away that dry mouth instantly. Ah, no more cotton mouth. I don't feel it. Tastes so good. I can totally feel it going down my system.
And you can see here with the participants, some believe that it will be hard for them, and it's hard for them. And some believe they're just gonna fly on a magic carpet over the process, and that's what's happened for them. We see their belief because me and the guides, we're very trained to be the observers. And sometimes we understand that certain people, it's gonna be hard for them, it doesn't matter what we say. We know it's a choice. And if you guys want to say a few words and share them with everyone.
Sounds good.
Remember, same rules apply. First 2 hours, every half an hour, just one. That's it.
Oh, God.
First, cheers.
Okay. I love you, beautiful water goddess. Thank you. I'm very grateful for you to come into my body and hydrate all my cells with all my love and gratitude. I'm like afraid to say it first. Whoa. It's very sweet.
Father, Son, and Mother Earth, thank you so much for providing this wonderful, I'm shaking, this wonderful, beautiful, divine substance. May it unite with my body. And be with me forever on my journey. May love and light be around me and everyone.
I just want to say like how incredibly grateful I am for this experience and mind blown that this is even possible. And one of the things that just really resonates with me is the fact that we've completely depleted all of the old water from our bodies, and the first class that's going in has been like blessed by everybody here. I love all you guys. And it's just it's just really awesome. I'm so thankful right now, and I'm so incredibly excited for this. Oh my God. I've always been a water guy, and I have such a profound new appreciation for water right now. It's fucking amazing. Thank you everyone for all of this. It's really, really powerful.
I have to say first that we focus on the integration, meaning we know that the people that are doing retreats, those come back to their house, to their lifestyle, and they go back to their old habits. So the two last days are workshops only on integration. How do I explain? To who do I explain? How do I keep this high level of energetic nourishment without wanting to eat again or without wanting to go back to the way things used to be. So we focus a lot on explaining. And during that time, we give tips from our own lives, because I've been living like this for 4 years. My friend has been living like this for over 5 years. And we have a small group of people that are already living this lifestyle, and we have these meetings and syncs. So, integration workshop.
Woohoo!
Yeah,
yay!
Yeah. This is a very important workshop. Like, it's a lot of us talking about our own experience. And basically, from now on, you guys are going to choose your own journey, your own experience. And some of you, I'll tell you the statistics, I'll be completely honest with the statistics. About half continue this lifestyle. Like, we can never really know who's going to continue and who not. We see that the intention exists in all of us.
We miss food, we miss its texture, the smell, the different tastes, and or also our old habits. So this, and I want you to know that it's not that all of you will have all of these challenges, but it's good to just be familiar with them and then like know what would be more challenging to you, and anyway you'll meet it on the way.
I can recommend you a few things. Also, we talked about it last night. Understanding that it's not only whatever it is that we eat or drink, it is the process and the ritual behind it. When you're bored in the office, you sometimes occasionally want to get up, and your excuse is to get up to take a leak, your excuse is to get up and make a tea.
So second one is Ray really spoke of, will be the social challenge, which is family, friends, social meetings, social events, weddings, you know, everywhere it's food.
I can tell them that the biggest challenge is not a physical one, because the physical energy comes back after a week or two. It's mostly with people. It's explaining to your mother that is completely programmed to think that you have to have a certain amount of food. It's explaining to your colleagues. It's sometimes being ridiculed and alienated because some people think it's too strange that you're going out with them and you're just sitting on the side and everybody's eating. that's my advice for the people who finish this process.
I think this was phenomenal. If I have feedback, it's not coming to mind right now for either of you. As far as like criticisms to change, is amazing, and if I have them in the future, I'll definitely send them your way and any insights. But I just feel so transformed. I was not expecting the level of inner transformation that happened, inner purging, inner letting go, inner investigation, and I was hoping for like a level of clarity to emerge. That was, I think, probably my ultimate desire, was this peace, and I call it a high. What I mean by that is just like this floating in your consciousness, kind of just a light feeling. And I certainly received that, and I'm so excited and feel in this group right here, right now, really committed to continuing this on to whatever level that takes me. And I feel really just so good in my spirit about it.
Yeah, I'm also finding myself in a lot of gratitude right now as we come to a close, and just I really feel like this process is unique, and unlike, even though I've never done another process, I just have this strong feeling that there's no other process is quite like this one in the world right now, and I just, to be the first in the first group to do this in the United States is just, it tickles me. It's like, I'm so lucky. How did I get so lucky?
I don't think there's one more workshop or any more time. I think it's absolutely balanced and thorough, just as it is. Yeah.
And this process seemed like a really good way to, for, like, longevity and health and well-being and vitality and being able to, you know, live another happy 30, 40 years if I want to.
The process was, as I said before, it was just so perfectly organized and perfectly placed. I felt, you know, with me, and I'm pretty sure a lot of the people here, you know, I couldn't have asked for better people to deal with. You know, the bonds we built, the conversations we had, you know, each one of you has a special place in my heart, you know, in my body now with that water.
Yeah.
You guys made the process really comfortable and really easy. I mean, couldn't ask for any two better guides. You know, you really made it comfortable. Unbelievable. And I never felt better in my life. And, you know, I've always been studying mind, body, spirit connection. And I finally, you know, put it together. How important this really is for mind and heart. You know, this extremely important.
This experience for me was one of the most profound, life-changing, paradigm-shifting. Like, I came here with really high expectations. I expected to have huge, you know, consciousness breakthroughs. I expected to, you know, have some real physical, you know, changes and whatever, and they've all been met absolutely and exceeded. And it's just been really powerful for me in so many ways. Like, I mean, I literally have clarity on my vision for my life. I have clarity in my belief systems now. I've opened up to new ideas and new possibilities. I mean, I feel like this has really leveraged my life in a way that I've never experienced in a single event.
You will be able to achieve in your body, in your mind, in your life. It's about abundance, it's about how we perceive ourselves, and it's about being in joy, in happiness, in love. The best advantage is that you have more time to yourself. And why is that? Because you're not digesting, then the body has more energy. That's like 2-3 hours every day. Plus, you're not shopping, plus you're not cleaning your you know, you're not cleaning the dishes afterwards, okay? You save money eventually. You have more time for yourself, so you go to sleep later and you wake up earlier, and you don't go to lunch in the middle of the day, so you can, like in my job, you just ride another half an hour, and you don't even go out. And I think that because a person has more time for himself and self-fulfillment, which is something that is missing here in our life, that is the biggest development. Because it comes from the fact that suddenly you don't need this frame of a marriage or university or work. Suddenly you have more time to be who you were supposed to be.